ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృత దుహే నమః. ఓం. డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, వెల్కమ్ టు ది స్టడీ ఆఫ్ గీత. వీ ఆర్ సీయింగ్ ది ఎయిత్ చాప్టర్, ది ఎయిత్ చాప్టర్ విచ్ వాస్ కాల్డ్ అక్షర బ్రహ్మయోగ అండ్ మెనీ అదర్ నేమ్స్ ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ, తారక బ్రహ్మయోగ, అక్షర బ్రహ్మయోగ, ధారణాయోగ, ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా. సో ఇన్ దాట్, ఇన్ ద వెరీ బిగినింగ్ వీ హ్యావ్ గాట్ సమ్ ఫ్రైటనింగ్ వర్డ్స్, అధియజ్ఞం, అధిభూతం, అధిదైవం, ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా. అర్జున ఈజ్ ఆస్కింగ్ సో మెనీ క్వశ్చన్స్ బికాస్ కృష్ణ యూజ్డ్ దోస్ టర్మ్స్ అట్ ది ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ ది సెవెంత్ చాప్టర్. అట్ ది ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ సెవెంత్ చాప్టర్ హీ వాస్ సేయింగ్ దోస్ హూ కమ్ ఆన్ దిస్ పాత్ ఆఫ్ భక్తి అండ్ దోస్ హూ పర్స్యూ మీ అండ్ మదాశ్రయ యోగం యుంజన్ మదాశ్రయ దోస్ పీపుల్ హూ సరెండర్ టు మీ అండ్ దెన్ హూ డూ భక్తి అండ్ హూ ఆర్ ఆన్ ద పాత్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ భక్తి, దే విల్ అటైన్, దే విల్ నో ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్. ఈ సెడ్ వాట్ ఆల్ హీ టోల్డ్ అబౌట్ సెవెన్ థింగ్స్. హీ టోల్డ్ వాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ బ్రహ్మ, దే విదు బ్రహ్మ విదుః కృష్ణం అధ్యాత్మం, బ్రహ్మ అధ్యాత్మం కర్మ. దెన్ అగైన్ హీ వాస్ సేయింగ్ అబౌట్ అధిభూతం, అధిదైవం, అధియజ్ఞం, ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా. హీ వాస్ సేయింగ్ ఆల్ అబౌట్ సెవెన్ థింగ్స్ ఈ సెడ్. సో అర్జున ఆస్ ద క్వశ్చన్ ఇన్ ద ఫస్ట్ టూ శ్లోకాస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ అధ్యాయ, దట్ ఈస్ 1 and 2 ఆఫ్ 8th అధ్యాయ. అర్జున ఆస్ వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ బ్రహ్మ, వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ అధ్యాత్మ, వాట్ ఈస్ కర్మ, వాట్ ఈస్ అధిదైవం, ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా హీ వాజ్ ఆస్కింగ్. నౌ వీఆర్ జస్ట్ రీడింగ్ ఎస్టర్డే, వీ జస్ట్ రెడ్ అవుట్ ది శ్లోక నంబర్ 3, దట్ ఈస్ ద రిప్లై బై లార్డ్ కృష్ణ. సో యాజ్ ఐ సెడ్, వీ నీడ్ నాట్ బి ఫ్రైటెండ్ బై దీస్ వర్డ్స్. కృష్ణ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్. I will make it much simpler. Third shloka is aksharam brahma paramam swabhavodhyatmam uchyate bhuta bhavodbhavakaro visarga karma sangeetah. So aksharam brahma paramam, up to that point is one line. That is, there was a question, what is that brahma? Krishna said, those who surrender to me, they will know what is that krutsanam brahma. Krutsanam brahma means that complete brahma, the complete comprehensive picture of that brahma. That is God, all about God, something like that. All about God, they will know. That is, you have got various ideas about God. Okay, God means at various levels we do visualize. That is, depending on our own ability to analyze, depending on our own ability to understand, depending on our own personal likes, dislikes, etc., we have got our own understanding of God. But what is the totality? What is the total picture of God? So that is what is that Brahma. సో భగవాన్ ఉవాచ, కృష్ణ ఈజ్ నౌ ఆన్సరింగ్, అక్షరం బ్రహ్మ పరమం. దట్ ఈస్ ది అన్వయ ఈజ్ బ్రహ్మ ఈజ్ పరమం అక్షరం, దట్ సుప్రీం, ఇంపెరిషబుల్. పరమ, పరమ ఈజ్ దట్ సుప్రీం. అక్షరం ఈజ్ క్షరతి ఇది క్షరం, క్షరతి మీన్స్ దట్ విచ్ డిక్లైన్స్, దట్ విచ్ డిప్లీట్స్. అక్షరం మీన్స్ దట్ విచ్ డస్ నాట్ అండర్గో ఎనీ చేంజ్, దట్ విచ్ డస్ నాట్ డిప్లీట్, దట్ విచ్ డస్ నాట్ పెరిష్, that which doesn't, that is what is called immutable, something which doesn't undergo any change. What is that? The only thing is that supreme reality. Supreme reality is the only thing which does not have any change. So aksharam brahma paramam, then swabha, and of course this aksharam, sometimes there is also a Vedic saying om ityeka aksharam brahma. This word om, om is brahma, so that is what Veda says in some places, that also is there. But here in this context, he is not referring to that Omkara as Aksharam. He is not referring to that Omkara. He is referring, Omkara is a symbol. Omkara is a symbol to denote Brahma. So here, he is not telling about that. Krishna is telling about that supreme reality. Then, Swabhavo Adhyatma Muchyate. Swabhavo Adhyatma Muchyate. After O, Swabhavo, there is something called, something which resembles to, it is called Avagraha. That means there is an implication, there is one A which is implied there. Swabhavaha Adhyatmam Uchyate. Then the second question was Adhyatma. What is this Adhyatma? Adhyatma, I told you the meaning. Several times we discussed it. Atmani iti Adhyatmam. It is called Avyayi Bhava Samasa in Sanskrit. Atmani means in the self. In the self means not only in myself, but in the self, inside, in the... In all the beings, what is that indwelling, what is that indwelling thing which is making us live, which is making us go about our duties, etc., etc. So that is what is called the pratyagatma. That indwelling thing is the pratyagatma. So he is going to explain swabhavo adhyatma muchyate. And what is that swabhava? Here commentators have said, swabhava is swarupam. what is called Pratyak Chaitanyam, what is the Swarupam, what is the actual Rupam, actual Swarupa of Supreme Reality. The actual Swarupa of Supreme Reality is what is called Satyam Jnanam Anantam. Satyam Jnanam Anantam is that pure consciousness. So Pratyak Chaitanyam, Shuddha Tvam Padartham, commentators have also said, Shuddha Tvam Padartham. In Vedanta, Vedanta says, Tat Tvam Asi. Tvam means that you, the Jiva, you who are identifying yourself with the body-mind complex, you are not that simple body-mind complex. Your essential nature is something else. Your essential nature is divine. So you try to discover that divine in you. That is what Vedanta says. So Shuddha Tvam Padartha. Then Swabhavaha Adhyatma Muchyate. That is, that which is in the body-mind complex of every being. Not only human being, but in all the ant, mosquito, etc., in all the antahkaranas, this is what is illumining all the antahkaranas, and this is what is making all the beings function as they are. Then svabhavodhyatma muchyate. Then the second line says, bhuta bhavodbhavakaro visargaha karma sanyitaha. This whole line is talking about what is called karma. Karma is what is called visarga, he says. Karma is visarga. Bhuta bhavodbhavakaraha visargaha karma sangnitaha. Karma sangnitaha means it is called karma. Karma sangna means what? Sangna is name. Sangnitaha means it is named. Karma sangnitaha means it is called karma. What is called karma? Visarga is called karma. And for that visarga, there is an adjective that is bhuta bhavodbhavakaraha visargaha. So visarga is, the meaning is visarga is, the Sanskrit word, by according to one commentator, is devatoddeshena dravyatyagaha. That is, you are performing some sort of yajna, and in that yajna you are doing some dravyatyaga. That means you are offering something not only into the fire. What we offer into the fire is very little. We don't offer whatever you have, you don't offer into the fire. What all we offer into the fire is some ghee and some coconuts, etc. But there is what is called distribution of money to various people. That is dakshina, in the form of dakshina. Yajnam adakshinam, we are going to see earlier, later. So dakshina is what all is given to various types of people. There are people who are reciting mantras, there are other people who are doing various odd jobs. So yajna was a sort of social activity in those days. Nowadays, because nobody performs yajna, and even if they perform yajna, okay, you are paying something, and then you are you go to a temple, you perform, you pay some money, and then they do some yajna, and they do give some prasada. But in olden days, yajna means an individual performs a yajna, and that individual distributes a lot of wealth to various people. In fact, in olden days, even now, there are people who perform yajna and then distribute what is called dhanam, dakshina. They give dakshina to so many people. So that is what is called karma. That is one karma, but by extension it also covers various philanthropic activities. We have seen the word yajna in 3rd adhyaya and 4th chapter of the same Gita. Krishna is giving a very, very elaborate definition for yajna. That is, yajna is any socially useful activity. That is, any activity which is going to help others is a yajna. And any activity which goes for self-purification. For example, the karma yoga is something which is for self-purification. We have seen that karma yoga is, you are acting in accordance with the cosmic scheme. You are acting in accordance to divine will. That means you are, like the God himself is there to help all the people, you are there doing your job in a perfect manner in order to help all the people. So then that is one way, and there are various other ways in which you are doing various types of benefit to others. And in fact, our dharma shastras, they talk about various things, like somebody gives money for some constructing a hospital, vapi koopa tatakaadya, they say. For example, in olden days, digging a well was an important function. So somebody digs a well, and that well, it is a source of water for so many people in the village. So digging wells, and then we digging tanks, village tanks, etc. And also laying roads, building hospitals, building schools, etc. All these things, they are all public activities. What nowadays we call them welfare activities. So all these welfare activities come under the term yajna. In fact, I was telling you that is the reason why even our politicians, knowingly or unknowingly, they call what is called Jala Yajnam or some other Yajnam. So, Yajnam is what, which is going to benefit lot many people. So, that is what is Yajna. And that Yajna is called Visarga. Devatodeshena Dravyatyaga Yaga Visarga Lakshanaha, says one commentator called Nilakantha. That is any ethical or philanthropic act. So, that is what is Visarga. So, this Visarga is called Karma. Karma or otherwise Karma, the meaning of Karma is that Visarga. And what is this Visarga? Bhuta Bhavodbhavakaraha. Bhuta Bhavodbhavakaraha. That is the cause for origin of all the beings. That is, our karma is the cause for all the for the next life. We know that karma is the cause for the next life. Of course, in karma yoga, we may have a question. Karma yoga, you are not getting the fruit. That is karma yoga. The very meaning of karma yoga is nishkama karma. Nishkama karma, where you are not desiring the fruit of that karma. Then what about where comes this punarjanma? That is because of the entire backlog of all the earlier karmas. The entire backlog is there. Karma yoga is definitely giving us chitta shuddhi. And definitely it is not giving phalam for whatever karma you are now doing. But for what all earlier is there, that is very much there. So this, and yajna, not all yajnas are done in karma yoga mode. We also should see that not all yajnas are done in karma yoga mode. Yajna, suppose somebody does some yajna, some Sudarshana yagam or some other yagam, Narasimha yagam, various yagams, we may do Rudra yagam, all these things. But for all these, people do desire. Of course, here, karma, it is not only referring to karma yoga. Karma is referring to any yajnam. Any yajnam, it is done. It is done expecting result. Punyam, lot of punyam. Yajna is usually done expecting punyam. And that punyam is definitely going to give a next birth. So, bhuta bhavodbhava karaha means, if you want to have the meaning in Sanskrit, that is bhutanam bhavaha. Bhutanam bhavaha, that is, and bhuta bhavodbhava karaha, that which is responsible for that bhutanam bhavaha, that is, that which is responsible for the origin of all the beings, that is what is karma. So, that is what is causing next birth. And because karma is something which is responsible for the next birth. So, this is, so here in this shloka, Krishna has answered 3 points. What is karma? What is Brahma? What is that adhyatmam? Adhyatma is something that is pratyagatma, which is there in everybody. Then pratyagatma, which is not different from that supreme atman. And this karma. This karma means this yajna is what is called karma. We'll just take a break and go to the next shloka. Let us resume. So, the next shloka, that is shloka number 4, it is again covering the 4 other subjects. 4 topics is adhibhuta, adhidaiva, adhiyajnam, and what is, 3 points. Next shloka is going to cover the last point, that is antakalesh, antyabhavana. So, this 4th shloka I will read. Adhibhutam ksharobhavah, purushascha adhidaivatam, adhiyajnyohamevasmi, dehe dehabhrutam vara. Dehabhrutam Vara is address. O Dehabhrutam Vara. Vara means Shrestha. Vara, we know that Vadhu and Vara, we know the words. Vadhu is the bride and Vara is the bridegroom. Vara in Sanskrit means Vrunite Dhatu. That is one who is chosen. Vara means a chosen person. We also have some names like Varavara, highly chosen person. So Varavara. So Varavara, this is a Vaishnava name. Some of these Vaishnava people, they do have that name, Varavara Acharya, etc., etc. So this Vara means Shrestha, highly respected, not respected, chosen, typically chosen person. So Dehabhrutam Vara, Shrestha, chosen, Shrestha Vachaka. Dehabhrutam Vara means, eminent among all the people, eminent among men. So that is usually Krishna addresses Arjuna in a rather, in a praising manner. Encouraging manner, let us say, not praising, encouraging manner. Then he says, the first line is, adhibhutam ksharobhavaha. What is this adhibhutam? Adhibhutam is, adhi means about, adhibhutam is that which is there in all the beings. That is what is adhibhutam. Adhibhutam is bhuteshu. That again is an avyayi bhava, like adhyatmam. Adhibhutam is again avyayi bhava, adhiyajnam is avyayi bhava, adhi daivam is avyayi bhava. that is coming in Saptami Vibhakti. Saptami Vibhakti means that locative case, if you want to see the grammar. Adibhutam is that which is in all the beings, what all we see, that which is in all the beings is Adibhutam. That is, all the beings means at a physical plane. You are the observer and you are observing the whole universe, and in this whole universe again it is reducible to the five elements called Prithivi, Apaha, Tejo, Vayu, Akashaha. In all these five elements, what is it that is there? What is the essence of all that? Adibhutam Kshaurabhavah. Kshaurabhavah is what? That is Kshara. Kshara is, Akshara is unperishing, undiminishing. Kshara means something which is diminishing, something which is changing. So the entire universe is something which is changing in nature. Adibhutam is something which is changing in nature. What all is that changing in nature? That is what we call Jagat. That is what is called Adibhutam. Jagat is, in fact, the meaning of Jagat, etymological meaning of Jagat also means the same. Etymologically it means Gachati iti Jagat. That which keeps on moving, keeps on changing. That is, the whole universe is always in a state of change, in a state of flux, let us say. Flux means it is again changing and changing. The universe was not like this a few thousand years ago or 1,000 years ago, and it keeps on changing. Even now there it is undergoing change. Similarly, all the beings, they keep on changing. They are born, they exist for some time and they pass away. And similarly, the universe also, it comes into existence and it goes away. Again, another universe comes into existence. So this is what is Kshaurabhavah, that is, which comes and goes. And Adibhutam Kshaurabhavah. Then Adidaivatam. Adibhutam talked about the physical plane. Physical plane means that which is observed physically. Adidaiva, it is now talking about what is called the divine plane. Adidaiva, the human being visualizes what is called Deva. And not only human being visualizes, there is one particular level, because we see that whole structure, if we see in Vedanta, the topmost level is what is called that supreme Brahman or supreme reality, which is of the nature of Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam. There is no activity in it, there is no change, it is something which is immutable. And in that, it has got an expressive power, and that expressive power what we call Maya or Prakriti and all that. And that Prakriti is something which is undefinable. Prakriti or Maya, that nature of Maya is, it is indefinable because it is just expressed in that consciousness is appearing as this matter, the whole universe which we are seeing. So this whole universe, whether it is real or unreal, that is the basic question. Even now, in science also, that is the basic question. So, Adidaivata. For the Adidaivata comes into picture in the sense that when in that supreme Brahman there is this manifestation called Maya. So the Chaitanya which is associated with Maya, Chaitanyam or consciousness which is associated with this Maya, it is called Ishvara. The technical word in Vedanta is Ishvara. Ishvara again we should not confuse with husband of Parvati. Husband of Parvati again Ishvara, Shiva, Rudra, etc. That is one tradition. Ishvara is a technical name given in Vedanta, like Brahma. Brahma does not mean that, Supreme Brahma does not mean the four-headed Brahma who is the husband of Saraswati. And similarly, Ishvara does not mean the husband of Parvati. So what Puranas say we have to keep aside for some time. We have to totally keep aside from our minds. Purana, okay, you remember the story for Purana, for the sake of Purana, and you enjoy that story. But then here in Vedanta, Brahma means that supreme reality, that is Satyam Jnanam Anantam, that is infinitely existing consciousness. Ishvara means that Maya Vachinnam Chaitanyam, that is Chaitanyam which is associated with the expressive power or manifesting power in that reality. So that is Maya Vachinnam Chaitanyam. Technically they use this expression. So that is what is Ishvara. And that is that, in that, again there is a cosmic mind. That cosmic mind is what is called Hiranyagarbha. And that, in fact, there is another name for that is called Purusha. Here in this shloka, that is the reason why I was saying all these words, they seem to be frightening. But once we just see the overall picture, then it is not frightening. The overall picture is very, very clear. Overall picture is that supreme reality that has got an expressive power called Maya. That Maya Vachinnam Chaitanyam, that Chaitanya which is associated with Maya is called Ishvara. And in that there is what is called a cosmic mind. That cosmic mind is the what we call Hiranyagarbha. and all God forms which we visualize, they all fall into that. They fall into that particular entity called Hiranyagarbha. In that Hiranyagarbha Tattvam, you are visualizing Vishnu, we are visualizing Shiva, you are visualizing Ganesha, Kartikeya, Shakti, and so many things, according to Vedanta. When you go to Purana, it's a different thing. Again, there is no contradiction. That again, it's a very big subject. Purana, again, when you see Vishnu Purana is extolling Vishnu, praising Vishnu as that supreme reality. If you go to Shiva Purana, it is praising Shiva as that supreme reality. If you go to Ganesha Purana, it praises Ganesha as the supreme reality. It may be like that, but we have to see that supreme reality, the nature of supreme reality does not change. So according to that particular sect, the followers of Vishnu may say something, the followers of Shiva may say something, but Vedanta accepts all those things. So anyway, here, Purushascha Adhidaivatam. So Adhidaivata, Adhidaiva again is Deveshu, as I was saying. Adhidaivatam, Adhidaivam, again is what is called Avyayi Bhava Samasa. Purushascha Adhidaivatam, Adhidaivatam and Adhidaivam are one and the same. That which is in the divine plane. What is in the divine plane? The divine plane, one reality is what is called Hiranyagarbha. And in that Hiranyagarbha Tattva, the cosmic mind, no religion can deny it, the cosmic mind will be there. Then one religion may give one name, another religion may give another name. And some other people may not go to that level of cosmic mind, and some other people may say, no, 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 my village god is like this, my village goddess is like this. So that is a different thing. So, but for all these things, all these forms are visualized in that cosmic mind. So that cosmic mind, which is called Purusha, and we are all familiar with what is called Purusha Suktam. When you go to a temple, the pujari or archaka keeps reciting this Purusha Sukta. If you are performing some puja, he will say, okay, Sahasra, Shirusha, Purusha, etc. He starts some mantras. So that is Purusha. In that Purusha Sukta, the same thing is told. So Purushascha Adhidaivatam. So at that level, at the divine level, it is called Hiranyagarbha. Then Adhiyajnyo Ahamevatra. Dehe Dehabhrutamvara. Dehe means in this body. In the human body, not only human body, but in all the bodies. He Dehabhrutamvara, oh my dear, eminent person. Adhiyajnyaha, ahameva. This Adhiyajna is myself. Adhiyajna, again, is what? Adhiyajna is that which is in Yajna. Adhiyajnam is in Yajna. Adhidaivam, in the gods. Adhyatmam, in the Atma. So, like that. So, Adhiyajna, who is that Adhiyajna? That was the question. Ahameva. I am that aspect of ahameva means I am that. What is that aham? So that is that aspect of that supreme reality which is present in us, which is enabling us to do all our good karma. Whatever good karma we are doing, it is because of that. We may also call it what we call conscience. Every human being has this sense of right and wrong. You have got a conscience. And according to that conscience, you are doing certain good things. So that aspect of Brahman which is there in all the beings, and in fact, Gita, this Sandhyavandana mantra also says the same. Sandhyavandana shloka is there, Dhiyo Dharmadi Gocharaha. Sandhyavandana mantra is different and shloka is different. Sandhyavandana mantra is, Gayatri mantra is, Bhurbhavasuvaha Tatsavitruvarenyam Bhargodevasya Dhime, etc., etc. Sandhyavandana shloka is the same mantra in the form of shloka they have put. That is, Yo Devas Savitasmakam Dhyo Dharmadi Gocharaha. People who do that Sandhyavandana, they know this shloka. Dhyo Dharmadi Gocharaha means all the beings, all the human beings and every being has what is called conscience, the sense of right and wrong is known even to the most villainous person. Even the most villainous person knows what is right and what is wrong. So a villainous person, he is aware that he can be caught by law and he can be persecuted, he can be prosecuted. But then still he continues that. Even a thief, he knows what is right and what is wrong. So that is the reason why the thief also comes without our knowledge. Sometime in the night, sometime choosing an opportunity, he wants to steal. So he knows, he has got that idea of right and wrong. So that is, every being has got this right, this awareness of what is right and wrong. So that Adhiyajna is my own self. Maybe I feel we can also call it a conscience or something like that. adhi yajnyohamevasmi. In fact, there is also a word called yajnyovai Vishnuhu. Yajna is what is called Vishnu. So here, yajnyovai Vishnu means all good activity is a manifestation of the divine. Adhi yajnyohamevasmi dehe dehabhrutamvara. That is all activity, all good activity is a manifestation of the divine. Then the next shloka, that is the fifth shloka. Antakalecha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram yah prayati samadbhavam yati nastyatra samshayaha. So this is talking about what is called antakala. So earlier in the last adhyaya, that is seventh adhyaya, Krishna was saying, that is he was talking about that antya bhavana, the last shloka of that yesham tvantakatam papam, yeah, 30th shloka he was saying. Prayana kalepicha maam te viduhu. Even at the time of death, they will know, they will be in my awareness, Brahman awareness. So that is what he was saying. So what is that Brahman awareness? Antakalecha, even at the time of death. Because at the time of death, normally there is a total physical frailty, all the limbs are weak, the mind may or may not be in a good condition. At that time, if you want to remember God, how can it happen? At that time, there may be so many thoughts in the mind, there may be thoughts about your property, there may be thoughts about your bank balance, there may be thoughts about your son, your children, your various other things. So you may be having all those ideas, but to keep away all those ideas and to have the idea of God, one should have done some little bit of practice. Unless we do some practice, it is not possible to practice, means abhyasa. We are going to see that word abhyasa in this adhyaya in the next few shlokas. So abhyasa is, we have to continuously on it. Abhi-asa. Abhi means about, asa means to be. Abhyasa means you are continuously on it. So unless we do this abhyasa, unless we are into that mode of bhakti right from the beginning. Suppose somebody says, okay, after retirement, let me read Gita. And okay, after retirement, okay, let me understand what is God, etc., etc. After retirement, there may be many other worries. There may be many other worries relating to settlement of children, settlement of this, that, etc., etc. So one cannot postpone. One has to go on, practice. Unless he practices that antyakala bhavana, antya bhavana, that final frame of mind. Why is this final frame of mind important? Because this final frame of mind, antya bhavana, is going to determine the next birth. Is going to determine whether it is you are going to have a next birth or otherwise. The otherwise means, that is, Krishna is going to say that antya kalecha mameva smaranti, whoever continues to meditate on me, he will attain me. So that means he will not have punaravartanam. That is, he will not come back. He will go to some loka from where he gets enlightened. We are going to see that structure. So in this adhyaya, we are going to see such things. This is, it may not look very, very rational. As Tattva Vidananda says, it is slightly metaphysical speculation. But it is a very logical speculation. That much we have to see. We will continue tomorrow. Harihi Om Tat Sat.